Good morning. My name is Elaine Geary, and I welcome. Today is the 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please remember to silence all electronic devices so we may maintain the dignity of today's celebration. If you are watching us on our Facebook stream, please feel free to comment your prayers, thoughts, and intentions. If you are watching us this morning on our website on DCAT, thanks for tuning in. And if you are watching us later today or this week on your YouTube channel, we hope this Mass brings you comfort. No matter where you are or how you got here, please know you are always most welcome at St. Richard's. The theme of today's liturgy, we are called to tend the vineyards of the Lord, who will judge our efforts at the end of time.
Good morning, everyone. Please stand and join us in our opening hymn, number 309, Gather Your People.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, and the crucified and risen Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
As we gather together once again to celebrate the Eucharist, we take a few moments to reflect upon God's great love for each of us and upon our response to the Lord and to our neighbor.
You have come to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpasses the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me now sing of my friend's song concerning his vineyard. My friend had a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He spaded it, cleared it of stone, and planted the choicest vines. Within it he built a water tower and he hewed out a wine press. Then he looked for the crop of grapes, but what it yielded was wild grapes. Now inhabitants of Jerusalem and people of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I had not done? Why, when I looked for the crop of grapes, did it bring forth wild grapes? Now I will let you know what I mean to do with my vineyard. Take away its hedge, give it to grazing, break through its wall, let it be trampled. Yes, I will make it a ruin. It shall not be pruned or hoed, but overgrown with thorns and briars. I will command the clouds not to send rain upon it. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judah are his cherished plant. He looked for judgment, but see bloodshed, for justice, but hark the outcry. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Its foliage to the sea, its shoots as far as the river.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
Why have you broken down its walls so that every passerby plucks its fruit? The boar from the forest lays its waste, and the beasts of the field feed upon it.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Listening, speak your words of wisdom, for the words you speak are everlasting life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard and put a hedge around it, and dug a wine press around it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to the tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and the one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again he sent other servants, more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance.' They seized him, threw him out in the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to these tenants when he comes?" They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease his vineyard to other tenants, who will give him the produce at the proper times." Jesus said to them, "Did you ever read the scriptures? 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes.' Therefore, I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Last week, the scriptures invited us to consider the importance of obedience in the life of faith. We were reminded that we are called to both hear and listen to God's voice so that we can obey God's commands and precepts, so that we can do the word of God. The scriptures this weekend speak to us about the opposite of obedience, about what constitutes rebellion and revolt against God, about disobedience. The wild grapes that Isaiah speaks about in the first reading this morning represent bad fruit or produce that the prophet associates with violence and injustice. In the parable of the vineyard in the gospel, Jesus is making it clear that some of Israel's leaders, the chief priests and the elders, are guilty of rebellion against God, as well as murder for their treatment of the prophets, God's messengers and representatives, and also that they will be accountable for their rejection of Jesus himself, who, of course, is God's son, represented by the son in the parable. The treatment of the prophets by the forebears of the elders and the chief priests and of Jesus himself is tantamount to rebellion and revolt against God. In Hebrew, there are multiple words for sin, each denoting a specific aspect of sin. The Hebrew word pisa connotes this specific kind of sin, which is about direct revolt and rebellion against God. Jesus will not respond to his adversaries with violence, however. He will not return evil for evil, but instead, Jesus will submit to his death on the cross, knowing that God will vindicate him. This is what Jesus means when he cites Psalm 118 and the verse, "The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. By the Lord, this has been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes." Jesus makes it clear to his detractors what the consequences of their faithlessness will be when he tells them that the kingdom of God will be taken away from them and given to a people that will produce its fruit. It is extremely important this morning that we not interpret this parable of the vineyard as God's rejection of Israel as his chosen people. God's covenant with Israel is eternal and irrevocable. This parable is an indictment of some of the leaders of Israel, and not Israel itself or the Jewish people. And it is critically important that we understand that this morning, especially in the light of the recent horrific terror attacks against Israel just 2 days ago. Christians see the church as the new people of God and the initial budding forth of the kingdom on earth. The church too, however, must always avoid resting on its laurels or status and instead seek to produce the fruit that God commands it to produce. This is why St. Paul admonishes the Philippians the way that he does in the second reading this morning, when he says, "Whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me." Paul is making it crystal clear that there is absolutely no room for complacency or self-satisfaction in the Christian life. Sin, ultimately, is about failure to do God's will, failure to do the very word of God. The tenants in the parable of the vineyard sought to steal the vineyard from the owner by killing his servants and ultimately his son. Their greed causes them to commit murder. This is why they will ultimately lose the vineyard. As Jesus' followers and members of his church, we are each of us called to produce the fruit of Jesus' own spirit, the spirit that was given to us at baptism and again at confirmation. The fruit of that spirit is love and joy and peace and patience and kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. God expects us to be constantly striving to produce this very fruit, not some of the time, but all of the time. Ultimately, it is by doing the word of God that we make our connection to Christ both manifest and real. The Eucharist is the sign through which we seek to witness to our commitment to Jesus and to his gospel. We go forth from the Eucharistic table precisely so that we can act in ways that show that we are indeed connected with Christ, producing the good fruit that his Spirit seeks to produce in us. As we join together in the Eucharist this morning, let us pray that through our reception of Jesus' own risen body and blood, that his life will indeed be made manifest in us, that his Spirit will produce in us the fruit that is love and justice and peace and the like. Please stand. I believe in one God, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. By prayer and supplication and with thanksgiving, let us make our requests known to God.
That the church may preach the kingdom, not as its private possession, but as a gift for which the Lord will one day demand an account. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations may live in peace, creating ways of justice, not bloodshed or oppression. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick and burdened with illness may be visited by the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the challenging messages of the parable strengthen us to produce a harvest worthy of the Master's trust. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our young people and senior parishioners may come to know and teach and treasure each other. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are bound on earth to Christ and his faith community, especially Kathleen Banyan, Irene Bertocci, Louis Philip Bouchard, Carol Alves, Ann Dillon, and Janice Pramus. May they be bound in heaven to the communion of the blessed. We pray to the Lord. For all the intentions presented online today, especially those held in the silence of our hearts, may the Lord hear them, heal them, and continue to bless us. We pray to the Lord.
Let us also remember the victims of the horrific terror attacks in Israel. May God grant peace and rest to the dead, healing to the wounded and the injured, and comfort and solace to the bereaved. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Yours, O God, is the vineyard and its harvest. Yours the kingdom of justice and peace. You call your people to tend its growth. Bless the work entrusted to our hands, that we may offer you an abundance of just works, a rich harvest of peace. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please join us in our presentation hymn number 810 in the Missal, This is the Day.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad for. This is the day that the Lord has made. Alleluia, alleluia. To God the Lord is good, God's mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, God's mercy endures forever. This is the day that the Lord has made, let us rejoice and be glad for. This is the day that the Lord has made. Alleluia, alleluia.
The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord. How wonderful in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad for. This is the day that the Lord has made. Alleluia, alleluia. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad for. This is the day that the Lord has made. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thank you.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your command, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with us.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord. It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored
unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
People, one love. Taste not this bread we share, the body of our Lord. Is not this wine we drink, the blood of Christ outpoured? One bread, one body, one cup, one call, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released. I am the bread of life, eat and you shall live. To those who share this meal, my strength I'll always give. One bread, one body, one cup, one call, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one
change our hearts this time. Your word said it can be. Change our minds this time. Your life could set us free. We are your people, your cause set apart. Lord, this time, change our hearts. Wrought by your hand to the edge of a dream, one foot in paradise, one in the waste. Drawn by your promises, still we are Lord. By the shadows and the chains we leave behind, but change our hearts this time, 'cause your word said it could be. Change our minds this time, your life could make us free. We are the people your cause set apart. Lord, this time, Lord, this time, please change our hearts.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Do the talk first. Please be seated.
We'd like to start out by talking about a new collaborative initiative. It's a parish-wide service day. It'll be a day of fun and service to all parishioners of both parishes. With so much need occurring around the globe these days, we thought we'd like to do something. We thought we should have a program here at home helping one another in our own parishes and neighborhoods. Everyone, no matter what season you are in your life, has a role in this day. The service day will take place on Saturday, November 18th, from 9 to 2. There are four important parts of this day. The first part of the service day involves parishioners who, for whatever reason, could use a little help around the home with yard cleanup, putting away summer furniture, getting clothes to donation boxes, turning mattresses, changing light bulbs, or even putting new batteries in smoke detectors. We would like to help to make your life a little easier. If you could use a helping hand, or know a friend or neighbor who could use a little help, don't be shy. Please fill out the work order forms that are at the back table behind there and also on the parish website. Take one for your neighbor or friend. Will you let us be a servant? Let us be as Christ was to you. The second part of the service day are the volunteers who would like to serve our neighbors and make their lives easier. We are looking for all able-bodied parishioners who would like to give a day of service to our neighbors. If you are single and like to meet other parishioners, or a family that would like to teach your children the value of service, or a teenager or confirmation student in need of service hours, or are you someone that finds they have a free Saturday, please come and join us. Get to know fellow parishioners as you allow the hands of God to work through you. Please go online or fill out the forms that ask for the volunteers to serve. These forms are also found in the envelope at the back of the table at St. Richard's. The third group of volunteers will be those that would like to take part in our day by baking. We would like to send our workers off with some tasty treats to keep their energy levels high. We would ask that you drop some goodies by 8:15 on Saturday, November 18th. Please write your name on the sign-up sheet for bakers if you're willing to do this. The fourth group of volunteers are those that are willing to pray for us. In our preparation for the day, for good weather, and for the joyful expression of God's love through our service, there's a sign-up sheet for you as well. As you can see, there's a need for everyone on this project. We would like to make November 18th a special day in our journey of faith and real successful day of service for the Danvers Collaborative community. There are deadlines for all these groups. All sign-up sheets are in the back of the church or on the bulletin board. Again, please look on the parish website for more details. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact any of the staff. Can you think of any better way to celebrate the true meaning of Thanksgiving? And thank you, and have a wonderful day. There are also a few brief announcements. First of all, a great time was had by all who attended the collaborative lawn party last Sunday at St. Richard's. It was a special thanks to Jody Meyer and her team of volunteers for a wonderful day, and congratulations to all the raffle winners. Over $1,700 was raised for St. Vincent de Paul in that afternoon, so thank you all. Nina Pension is starting an 8-week practical spirituality course for moms of preschool, elementary, and middle school children, beginning this Thursday from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. in the House of Prayer. More details are in the bulletin. The pregnancy Care Center will do a baby bottle dry. Empty bottles will be available in baskets as you leave the church next weekend. We invite you to take one home, fill it with loose change or a check made out to the Pregnancy Care Center, and bring it back to our church by the weekend of October 22nd. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass has ended. You may go in peace.
Thanks be to God. And please join us in our closing hymn, number 390, City of God.
Awake from your slumber. Arise from your sleep, a new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. Let us build the city of God. Let our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, the light and our love, has turned the night into day. We are sons of the morning. We are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all kindness has called us to be a light for his people, to set their hearts free. Let us build the city of God. Let our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day.
Have a wonderful day, everyone.